Hi students, welcome to learn the new lesson today. Look at the trees in the picture. We can find the trees in the forest, on the roadside, in the surroundings, in the different campuses, and there are many uses of the trees. Trees are used in building the buildings, making the furniture. And there are so many useful things where we can use the trees. So today we shall learn a lesson where the tree is made use in building. But let us see whether the tree is made use or no. So the name of the lesson is The Great Spirit of the Sal Tree. The lesson number is lesson 5. First, I will read the lesson part by part, then I'll explain to you. Listen to it. Once upon a time, a king of a North Indian kingdom wanted to build a palace more remarkable than any other in the country. He could not make it richer, taller, stronger, or more beautiful without great expense and trouble. So he decided to make it special in another way by setting the whole palace upon a single wooden column, a column carved from one of the biggest trees in his kingdom. He sent for his minister and said, "Send men to my forest far and near and tell them to cut down and bring to the city without delay the mightiest tree they can find." 30 foresters were dispatched, but they soon returned saying that though there were many trees equally strong and gigantic in the king's forest, could never carry or drag them over the difficult terrain that lay between the forest and the city. Once upon a time, a North Indian king wanted to build a beautiful palace. So he thought of building it in a special way. How? He wanted his palace to be built with a single wooden column. Column means pillar. So he's calling his minister and he's telling that to send men to the forest and bring the mightiest tree from the forest. So the forest, 30 foresters are going to bring the mightiest tree from the forest. They see the trees, but they are unhappy because they cannot even carry or drag the tree to the city from the forest. The king heard this, but later he sent for the foresters again. By means of horses, one of these trees must be brought here, he said. It is not possible, they said. No horse could move such a tree even an inch. By means of bullocks, then, he said. The bullocks could not possibly force their way through miles of such dense forest. By means of elephants, then, it is hardly possible, for the ground is so marshy that the elephants would sink to their knees in it. Very well, said the king angrily. If you cannot bring me such a tree from the forest, then you must find it within one of my village parks. Bring it here within a week. So after hearing this, the king tells them, take the help of the horses, bullocks, and elephants so that you can bring and carry and drag the mightiest trees to the palace. So, at last, they tell to the king that even the horses, bullocks, and the elephants cannot carry those mighty trees. So, the king tells them that if they cannot bring it from the forest, they have to bring it from the village parks. The foresters left and went directly to a splendid sal tree which grew not far from the palace. It was worshipped by the people of many villages around because within it dwelt a tree spirit who gave the tree its great strength, size and beauty. The foresters decided with much reluctance that the king's column must be made from this lordly sal tree and from no other. They returned to it with garlands, lamps and music to offer them to the spirit inside and to warn him that he must leave his abode, for within 7 days it would be cut to the ground. So the foresters are leaving the palace and they are directly going to the splendid sal tree. Splendid means vast, which was near the palace. But the tree was worshipped by the many villagers because inside the tree there was a tree spirit. Spirit means supernatural being who gave the tree its great strength, because that spirit was giving the strength to that particular tree. So now the foresters are deciding. What they are deciding? To tell the tree that the kings want to build the palace with that tree with one column, so that the palace looks beautiful. And then they are returning to the village with garlands, lamps and music to offer them to the spirit inside. So they are offering garlands, lamps and music for the spirit which is inside the tree, and tells the spirit that it should leave within 7 days because within on the 7th day they will be coming to cut down to the ground. The tree spirit heard and understood well enough what was about to happen. It remained quiet as a resting breeze blew for a few moments. Then all his leaves began to whisper and his topmost branches bowed, and the foresters went away satisfied that he had answered their plea. But this was what the leaves were whispering to each other. Now, after the foresters left, the tree spirit, trying to understand everything, it remains quiet. But then leaves started to begin to whisper to each other, and the topmost branches are bowing. So the foresters think that they accepted their plea. Plea means the request. So they happily moving. So the leaves are whispering to each other. What are they whispering? Whether they have to accept the king's decision. If they accept the king's decision, they will die. The spirit will also will die. And the children also will die. At least for the children's sake, they wish that king had to change his decision. So the spirit within the tree thought that it will not make the king to cut the tree. So it decides to go into his dream. The spirit went in king's dream and spoke this way: I am the spirit of the sal tree, O king. Your foresters this day have told me of your decision to fell me. Fell me means to cut me. I have come to beg you to change your mind. So the sal tree is requesting the king to change his mind. King is not agreeing to it. So the sal tree spirit is begging again and telling that the so many uses that the sal tree is giving to the people around. The birds are nesting, the people are taking lovely shade, and there is grass beneath it. against his trunk people rest, and there are so many wild creatures which find coolness. So the earth is blessing that tree. Still, the king said he will not change his mind. Then the spirit is begging to cut him into three parts. How it is? First, the head, the crown, waving greenery. Next, the middle, 100 strong arms and the hands. And the last, heaviest and the knottiest of the limbs upon it. So the king is surprised to hear this request, because he is hearing for the first time. So he is asking, why can't you suffer the pain only once instead of three times? So the tree says, the spirit of the seed tree says that there are dozens of young salt trees which are sprung from it and generously giving the shade to others. So if this tree is cut, all the other small trees will be crushed and there will be no more salt trees. At last the king says, indeed it is. That means he is agreeing upon. Next day the king calls his minister and tells him that he has changed his mind. The column for the new palace should be built of stone and not of wood. Within the salt tree dwells a spirit nobler than my own. That my own means nobler than the king. And he told them of his vision and they all marveled. So this is lesson 5, the great spirit of the salt tree. Thank you for listening.